Okay, children, back again. We are now on page number 35. Finally, we moved on. We are now going to talk about the intensive subsistence. Now, before I move on, the word intensive. Intensive kind of farming, like we've heard in the previous class, especially class 8, is the kind of farming which requires a lot of input. A lot of investment has to be made, whether it is in the terms of land, whether it is in the term of labor, whether it is capital. Capital is, I hope you remember, capital is money. Or whether it is in terms of technical use of implements like tractor, the thresher and stuff like that. Now, first of all, intensive farming is done for areas which have high population, because quite understandable that the dependency of population on agriculture will be more. So it is better to have this kind of farming method followed in such areas. If you compare this with primitive is basically done in villages where the population to be fed is that of the village itself. Now, intensive farming is for the places like cities, towns around those areas. Now, we understand the meaning of the word labor intensive. Labor intensive, like I said earlier, is that a lot of labor has to be employed for the farming purposes in intensive farming. We talk about the chemicals, the fertilizers, the seeds, the amount of water. Everything is high dose. It is intensively put into the agriculture to increase the yield, increase the productivity. Now, it is not practical in India because we have these inheritance laws. The same piece of land passes from the father to the son, from son to the sons, and further like that. Taking an example, if we have this piece of land belonging to one father, the father has say four sons, the piece of land breaks into four. Sons further have sons, thereby dividing the land holdings into smaller and smaller pieces, on which doing intensive farming will prove to be more expensive, and that is why people usually give up their land holdings and they move to cities looking for jobs. And this kind of issue we are facing in India, because you see, the population is increasing, and at the same rate that the population is increasing, we do not have increase in the amount of land available to us. That remains as a fixed resource. So then what people do is that they sell the small holdings to maybe their own family members, who consolidate them. And if there are a member of four, if there's a family of four sons, then maybe two of them move on to cities or looking for other professions. Only two of them land up doing farming, and these two might still have enough holding. They can continue intensive farming. But keep in mind, as and when the division of the land holding takes place and the land holding size is being reduced, then slowly it shifts to subsistence farming, wherein which only the family members actually attend to the agricultural practices. Only if the land holding is huge, intensive farming is carried out.